A country makes its people, and some people also help to make a country. Namibia has made Gwen Lister, and Gwen has helped to make Namibia. She has done this in a reciprocal way, not for personal glory, but as payback for the opportunity to be alive and aware about the need to fight injustice.
When my family relocated to Namibia in 1988, we left behind a very volatile South Africa, but I soon came to learn that colonialism and apartheid had manifested itself in a very similar but also different way. And I also soon came to know this iconic newspaper headed by this fearless female editor, Gwen Lister, who dared to tell the story of Namibia and its people in a way that no one else dared. It was inspirational.
The first experience with Gwen, one thing always stands out with what she always tried to impact in new young reporters is to always learn more. And one thing that I remember on top of my head is that she emphasized on me getting a dictionary so that I can learn a word each day when I go to bed. That was, an important lesson for me to just improve my craft as I do it today. So it was really an honor of working with her.
Congratulations, Gwen. You've had a remarkable career as an activist journalist in Namibia and as a committed press freedom advocate in Southern Africa, the continent, and the world. On the day of Chris Hani's funeral, after chaotic scenes in Dawn Park, Johannesburg, and elsewhere in South Africa, I was a rookie journalist at the time, and my dad called me from Cape Town. He told me that journalism was too dangerous and that I should quit. It was his last words to me as he died just hours later. I stuck it out, and it was people like you, Gwen, that continue to inspire me. You were one of my role models as I tried to find my place as a journalist in South Africa and as a press freedom advocate, and you remain so. I'm so very pleased that you've chronicled your remarkable journey in this way. And I hope that it will inspire other young girls around our continent. And to paraphrase Margaret Mead, whom you quoted, that those girls, and especially those who want to become journalists, will be left with no doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens, and here let me add journalists like you, Gwen, that they can change the world.
Throughout the years, I've seen Gwen as someone who's a nurturer, someone who guides you, a firm but fair way of nurturing you. She has inspired a lot of us to become journalists in what she has achieved and what she has gone through over the years. Before independence, obviously, her story is very well told. We are just proud to be able to continue her legacy, and hopefully we are doing a good job at showing the world that Gwen touched our walk. She helped get us to where we are today. And we just want to congratulate her on obviously her publishing her book and telling her story, and so that other people can get to know the Gwen that we also got to know.
One of my inspirations, what I've learned from Gwen, is that you are a hard worker who never takes sick leave, who's really not on leave, and that makes us to believe that you have to do everything that you do to the best of your abilities, not make excuses, and take any opportunity that comes to your way in a positive way and make the best of it.
You instilled in me a deep appreciation for the power of journalism to change the lives of people. And I'd like to think that we today at the Namibia Media Trust, the NMT, we facilitate exactly that.
Soon after we first met, you sitting in your big armchair in Verdi Street, portrait of Che Guevara above you, cup of tea in hand, brimming ashtray next year. That was 33 years ago. You had a fantastic story to tell then, and I believe it's going to be even more of a fantastic story now. We can benefit from the wisdom and the hindsight that comes with time.
Her weapon of choice in all this has been journalism, telling it like it is in the public interest. And Gwen not only has done this journalism, she has been part of building an institution, the Namibian, which, unlike its counterparts elsewhere in the world, has survived and thrived, and today is a national asset for Namibia. I would like to thank Gwen in her history for co-chairing with Pierce Njawe, the late Cameroonian editor, the original UNESCO Windhoek Conference held in 1991, which gave the World Press Freedom Day. And I want to thank Gwen, along with Toivo Njabeni, for being the co-champions of this year's World Press Freedom Day conference in Namibia, which produced the Windhoek Plus 30 declaration.
I would like to say congratulations to Gwen for finally having reached this point and having Comrade Editor finally published. I can imagine it will be a page-turner, a thrill-a-minute, you know, and entertaining read.
Gwen, you've done it. The memoir is out. Congratulations. I'm so excited to read it. And I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud to have known you. And I'm so grateful for all that you've done for us as journalists in Africa. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I know that there's so much that you've had to leave out. And it really speaks volumes to the life that you've lived. We are so grateful for all that you've done. And we look forward to hearing lots and lots more.
So if journalism is the first version of history, then presumably a book by a journalist is the second version. So many, many congratulations, and thank you, Comrade Editor, for bringing us Comrade Editor.
I want to also thank Gwen for producing this book, an educational and inspiring resource of relevance to all Namibians, but indeed of much wider value as well. Well done, Gwen.
So thank you, Gwen, for another act of bravery, for so selfishly sharing your story with us. We are proud of you, so deeply proud of you, Comrade Editor.